Cardinals trailhead. A local was there to welcome me. The trail followed the edge of a grassy meadow. This land was part of the Granite Peaks Ranch. My first wildflower on the trip, fireweed. After about 3 miles, I approached the wilderness boundary. I did a little fishing and got my dinner. I saw some potentilla, if it's important to you. Soon the sun began to set. Day 2 began with an amazing sunrise. I packed up camp early and headed further into the wilderness. I saw several types of wildflowers along the way. There was brilliant trail construction through a marshy area. After a couple hours of hiking, I found a camp with a view. I caught some more fish for dinner, and I enjoyed the rest of the evening. Early the next morning, I found myself hiking beside the Los Pinos River with a large waterfall tumbling down a granite cliff on the far side. It was easy hiking through the flat valley. The surrounding mountains were grand. Cut through a beautiful grove of aspen before ascending an incline with amazing views and more flowers. Now the entire valley lay beneath me. Soon, I began to approach a magnificent spire at the head of the Flint Creek Canyon. Beavers had been very busy here. I caught a glimpse of the scenery to come. Colorado State Flower, and others. Side streams were cascading down the mountainsides. A new type of columbine. I saw steep peaks and grassy glades. I found a wildflower-filled meadow to camp at. is the meadow outlet stream before the storm. It was the wettest night of the trip. I awoke to another amazing morning. There was alpine glow on the high peaks. Mist began to rise over the meadow. The water had risen in the outlet stream. I had to negotiate a very difficult stream crossing on a slippery log. There were more cascades off the side hills. A different type of wildflower. Next, the trail took me up to an area of high peaks. There was still unmelted snow in July. As I approached Flint Lakes, the mountains became massive. I took a photo of the trail sign to prove where I'd been hiking. I was about 20 miles from the trailhead. Finally, I arrived at Flint Lakes. It was mostly cloudy when I arrived, but the fishing was excellent. I saw my first camp visitor. She ate my fish heads. Good morning, day 4. Possibly the most beautiful morning of the trip. I tried to capture the majesty of the sunlight hitting the mountains as the sun rose. Next, I decided to do a loop trail day hike from camp. And there were some nice views along the way. By Ute Lake. that, I hit large expanses of meadow. Early July was the perfect time for wildflowers. Next, I passed by Twin Lakes. Then I hiked up a ridge with great views. And more wildflowers. There were a few little ponds tucked in amongst the rocks. Then I got an aerial view of my campsite at Flint Lake. Up here is where I got some of my favorite photos of the entire trip. Funky fungi. Back at camp, I had another visitor. Brings us to day 5. I got up before sunrise to hike around the lake to find a spot where I could see the mountains reflecting into the lake and photograph it at sunrise. It was just kind of a fun thing to do. Here are some of the shots I took. It provides kind of a short time lapse of the sunrise that morning. After packing up camp, I hit the trail again and started hiking towards Rock Lake. Again, there were spectacular views everywhere I looked. Same old, same old. Welcome to Rock Lake. My trail is going to take me up over that ridge on the far side of the lake. This was one of the most interesting sections of trail. It took me up a talus slope to the top of the ridge amongst snowfields and just amazing views. Over the summit was a view of Moon Lake. That's where I'm heading next. Half Moon Lake was kind of pretty too. In the distance is Mount Oso, just shy of 14,000 feet. Several waterfalls along the stretch between Moon Lake and Emerald Lake. I found myself in a glacially carved valley. And at Emerald Lake. The next morning I went fishing. And I caught one of the biggest rainbow trout of my life. I had another camp visitor, although he kind of turned out to be a bit of a pest. other visitors as well. The river right next to my camp seemed to be a favorite place for deer to cross the stream. Let's not forget the little guy too. Fishing time. And I ate well that evening. There's one that I let go. Those are the ones I kept. Also found some blueberries. And finally, I hit the trail and went home. Thanks for watching.